as well. The pole is a fishing rod. I mean, what more can you ask for? He's got this amazing yellow, like, bucket rain hat on with that little fish there. Didn't even notice that. It's just a beautiful skin. And as you can tell, we're in the mid lane against a Riven, which is kind of awkward because Rivens do quite well in the mid lane. I mean, there was a time where Faker was playing Riven mid a lot, and that was quite possibly the worst time in my life. Everybody played Riven mid, and she's so good at the dueling, which sucks because, as you can see, it's just a lot of damage. A lot of damage. But I think we can, you know, just sustain and remain in the membrane, drop some dope beats and rhymes at the same time. Drop some dope beats. And yeah, I'm just pretty much going to stay in experience range. Not going to go too deep for all the experience because, every last hit, because it's just not worth it. Because honestly, going for one last hit, I'm going to lose, like, legitimately half my health with this level advantage. So we'll just wait, sit under tower, and look at this. There we go, baby. That's some beautiful stuff there. Need to last hit it a bit earlier. Oh, yes, okay. 8 CS to 10, so we only missed out on 2. To me, that's pretty good. There's not bad. Alright, there we go. Now it's getting screwed up. But we didn't die, and we do have that crystalline and 3 pots. And all she has is 1 pot, so if we get a bit of poke off, as long as she cannot sustain it, we gonna be good, bruh. We gonna be good. I'm gonna use my E and go for the engage here, just so I can get the Cata minion. But as you see, I lost half my health. She lost like 1/3, so not too bad, I guess. Actually, that went better than expected. And the thing is, I knew my E was gonna end up getting me the Cata minion, so I was like, this'll be alright. Oh, see, I could have gone in with the E, but I was scared I would die before the jungler got there. Bit of a bitch play, but I see he's coming around. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, no. What can I do here? What can I do? Oh, the flash. Okay, I easily could have got the kill, but the flash out is too much. I'm looking for a play. Got Ignite up. Should probably pop the crystalline flask. I mean, this minion wave is huge. Oh god. Come on. Where's the plays at? When the plays at? Alright, check this. Yes, 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 yes! Rengo! Oh baby! Oh! Where you at though? Where they at though? Where they at though? Oh mate! Meaty mate in the middle of Meterstein is honestly what went on there. You know what I'm saying? That was redonkulous. Yes, I said redonkulous. What it do? What it do, baby? And we just gotta back it off. Waves have reset in the middle of lane, and that is beautiful. I am completely and entirely happy with that. Only one CS behind. And that was a wicked little jungle interaction there. And we came out best. Alright, so now a lot of people... Oh, okay. I was about to start a bit of a rant about Sheen. Honestly, I'm not entirely sure, but I don't think Lich Bane first item is the best option because it doesn't scale that... I mean, it scales alright, but it doesn't do much damage until you have a lot of AP, I think, because... Let me just check. But, well, for example, Lich Bane doesn't. But I guess Sheen would be good for the early damage, but I think maybe Lich Bane, you know, second or third item. I was really lacking DFG first item on Fizz when I was building it. But regardless, it doesn't matter. Any of that doesn't matter because I want to get that Seeker's Arm Guard as the first item whenever you're playing against AD mids, whether it's Yasuo, Riven, Zed, or Jace. You want this beautiful baby. And it's kind of like Rod of Ages. A lot of people don't realize that, it actually stacks up. Great bait, mate. Oh, okay, okay. Almost a great bait, mate. But it stacks up, so after you get 30 CS with this, like the old Bloodthirster used to be, you will get extra armor, so that's really good. She's got no flash, but she's got that shield, and that's a really good thing about Riven in the mid lane. Her shield and plus her jumps from her Q is almost like the entire lane, so you don't have to be too worried when you don't have flash. I'm scared of going for the Riven. He's got this alone, he doesn't need me. I was scared this was gonna like do a lot of damage when I was trying to get to the Kha'Zix. Oh. Crystalline flask, baby! Crystalline flask, baby! Where are you at? Oh, someone's there! Someone's there. Oh, that's Teemo. Oh, that's Teemo. Teemo.